morning children. In the last class we saw how to plot graphs and how to represent uniform and non-uniform motion through graphs. Today we will see how to calculate speed, distance and acceleration using distance time graphs and velocity time graphs. So look at this graph. We can see this is a distance time graph. I have taken distance on the y axis and time on the x axis, and I have mentioned the scale also. If you see here, on x axis 1 cm is equal to 1 hour, and on y axis 1 cm equal to 10 kilometers. Okay, now just try to recollect the formula of speed. We know that speed can be calculated using this formula, distance by time. So in case we are calculating the speed of this object, we know by looking at this graph that the object is moving with uniform motion. So looking at this object, in case we need to calculate the speed of the object between 2nd and 4th hour. Okay, I have represented 2nd hour as t1 and 4th hour as t2. So I am going to calculate the speed of the object between these two time intervals. Okay, so by the formula we know speed equal to distance by time. So here if I see here, speed equal to at t2, if I see the distance is s2, you can just put dotted lines and verify. At time interval t2, the object has traveled a distance of s2, and at time interval t1, the object was at a distance 20 km or at s1. Okay, so speed equal to distance covered by the object, which is s2 minus s1, all right, by time interval, which is t2 minus t1. We will always take the final distance and the final time first, followed by the initial distance and initial time. So s2 minus s1 by t2 minus t1. If I just substitute the values, you will see that s2 is equivalent to 40 kilometers. Alright, you can use a ruler and check out the values, and in case you are using a graph, you can directly infer that it is 40 kilometers. So s2 is 40, s1 is 20, t2 is 4 hours, and t1 is 2 hours. So substituting the values, we get this 40 minus 20 by 4 minus 2. So you will get it as 20 by 2, and if you again simplify it, you will get it as 10. And since we are calculating the speed, the unit here is kilometer per hour. So in case you are given a graph with all the values and you are asked to calculate the speed, then you are going to use this formula. And remember, when we were calculating speed, we used s2 minus s1 by t2 minus t1. If you see here, this was the initial distance which the object has covered in time t1. We are just marking it using the point A. Okay, and then the final distance was B. So if you just extend this line from B to the time axis and extend another line from A to the perpendicular to the distance axis, you will get a point C. So S2 minus S1 will be equivalent to BC, and T2 minus T1 will be equivalent to AC of this triangle ABC. So this BC by AC, which helps us to calculate the speed, is termed as the slope of the graph. And a slope of the distance time graph will help you to calculate the speed of the moving object. Remember, speed can be calculated by using slope of a distance time graph. This helps you to calculate the speed.